The adrenochrome bust you never heard about. Front page news. Posted by Yike Wilson. On August 14th, 2019 at 7:37 a.m. in Daily Articles. This is going to be a little tricky trying to bring you this story because it goes back in time to when Q was first posting. October 30th, 17 to be exact. This was before Q was even Q, but you will see these drops on the Q map if you go back to the beginning. Thing is, this isn't about Q at all. This is about another anon that was posting at the same time. I was on the board for CHAN when this occurred and I remember it quite clearly. The drop this anon made occurred over four different board posts. So you are basically looking at over 1,400 comments to wade through. I'm not going to make you do that. I am going to bring out the relevant pieces though and try and give you the short story to a very long story. As it happens in the world of the chans, this anon got named rather quickly. Oddly enough, the other anons took to this anon much quicker than they did Q and gave him a much easier time. We named him Highway Patrolman. I will call him HP going forward. The crazy thing about this bust is because of one stupid trucker that didn't keep an eye on his weight load and HP's team happened to pull them over for a check. This is where the conversation started all about it on the board. Anon, Turdo connection can be, he took money from source, documented and can be found in articles from CBC. He gave money to Clinton Foundation, our money, could also be in talks to give Clinton, source, and their hell spawn safe haven, or maybe he had some spare native children to donate to their cause. Who the fuck knows for sure? HP, I reckon some free native adrenochrome and the rest. My team just seized a shipment of dried adrenochrome, 20 kilograms, that was marked for shipment to Canada. We thought that it was cocaine or some other narcotic and thus seized it. Our test kits gave no indication and we sent it to lab. Results came back as human adrenochrome, which freaked the fuck out of the lab technicians. Of course, HP was asked about this comment and when it happened. HP, it was a few days ago, but we are keeping it in one of our secret evidence locations, until it found who shipped it and whom the recipient was supposed to be. 20 kilograms is literally worth, at least, $100 billion. No use contacting the feds or RMCP about it either. We have no idea really what to do with it, besides keep it or dump it far out in the ocean. Where was it supposed to go? HP, Yukon Territory, which is making no sense to us. Another anon was trying to call him out about it being dried adrenochrome. HP, more like flash frozen. It was discovered in a track trailer refrigeration unit. It was weighing in 100 kilograms over declared weight at one of our weighing station. I do not even know what adrenochrome like that would be used for, but apparently, it can be used as an oxidation agent. Anon, as far as it going to the Yukon, all I can guess is that they were banking on it getting there, hoping that the weigh stations were gonna think it was just winter supplies. From there, they can take all that and repackage it for resale in a place where absolutely no one will give a shit, and there is zero surveillance. Then, you can transport it on smaller planes to locales throughout the world. I'm guessing that they've figured out how to long-term store it, even in liquid form, so it doesn't lose the high one gets from it. Have your investigators looked at the specific town it was destined for to see who owns what there? That would be my next guess, especially the address it was destined for. HP, I told them to look at location in more detail without going through the RCMP as much as plausible. Could large enough doses be used for assassinations or homicides? That is their unofficial theory for now, besides it being used in oxidation agent or for unknown reasons. Now of course at this point Q has been kind of forgotten and all eyes are on HP. Most of what we have learned over the last couple years came up such as spirit cooking etc. I will save you all that reading. The fact that it can parallelize you did come up in this is what HP said to that. HP, that is sounding even more plausible than other theories from an LE standpoint. Maybe, it is how Justin Castro is controlled. Adrenochrome can induce schizophrenia too apparently. Researchers Abram Hoffer and Humphrey Osmond claim that adrenochrome is a neurotoxic, psychotomimetic substance, and may play a role in schizophrenia and other mental illnesses in what they call the adrenochrome hypothesis. The researchers speculated that meg doses of vitamin C and niacin could cure schizophrenia by reducing brain adrenochrome. However, these hypotheses have never been scientifically accepted. Adrenochrome is not currently believed to have any psychedelic properties. Now this is where it gets interesting outside of what we already know. Remember the oxidation. Anon, C. Opera-induced oxidation of epinephrine. So whoever shipped this ship is literally shipping it en masse to a major mining firm whose primary product is copper. And copper is used for adrenochrome. So you just stumbled on one of the major locations of adrenochrome for the elite, all because some fucktard fucked up how much to load onto a trailer. The Capstone website says that their major operations are Minto, YT, Cucho, BC, Pinto Valley, AZ, Cozumel, State of Zacatecas, Mexico, and Santo Domingo, Region 3, Chile. So I bet that these are also major distribution slash manufacturing facilities for adrenochrome worldwide, used by the elite and their forces. Maybe have your investigators look around the Arizona location, as no one will bat an eye. I bet that the firm that sent it to the Yukon also sends it to AZ. Someone did ask if the driver had a manifest of where he was going. HP, Emerson, North Dakota Crossing. The rig was to be handed off to another driver in Calgary. And now the copper mines come into play. HP, I found why copper would be important. https://www.ncbi.nlm.nih.gov/pubmed/12727220. Seeing as this board has been archived, I don't mind giving you the link to it if you would like to read it over yourself. I know you Chan readers know how to follow it. The digs do start going into the Indian reservations and some shell companies come up also. Page 1 of HB drop on 4chan. Some digs. It turns out that Imperial Metals slash Selkirk Metals don't have an Upper Midwest mining op, just a Nevada one. But they are financially insolvent. https://www.bloomberg.com/news/articles/2017-10-27/billionaire-investor-struggling-canadian-miner-again. Billionaires Murray Edwards and Bruce Berkowitz are billionaires saving Imperial Metals again. So, these two billionaires are involved in a failing mining company that is tied with a Canadian tribe that is receiving adrenochrome. What are their connections with China and, say, the Rothschilds? Probably connections to the Rothschilds. Hell, I bet that they are using the Selkirk Corp to do their dirty work in importing slash exporting. The wiki for Imperial Metals says that the Nevada mining op is current. https://en.wikipedia.org/wiki/imperial_metals_corp. More HP. HP, I am looking at Mayo and such clinics in AZ to see if I find any links. Buying copper to synthesize vapor. Found out silver oxide, Ag2O, is also used as an oxidizing agent for synthesis of adrenochrome in addition to copper. That ties in mining even more. The 20 kg, 44.1 pounds, of adrenochrome that we confiscated is worth, at least, $100 billion, using research pricing. We lab tested the adrenochrome and came back as human. The only to extract ingenious epinephrine and a small bit of adrenochrome is through the adrenal glands of recently killed humans. Copper, silver oxide, and serious other minerals can be used to synthesize adrenochrome from indigenous epinephrine. This link will take you to page 2 of the drop roll. If you wish to read it all yourself, this is from a third page and I'm going to use it for the summary. You can read page 3 here. If you would like to read all of it yourself. Summary. HP, the cargo was shipped from Côte d'Ivoire via a shell company, AJAS Shipping and Freight. We and other agencies around the country have intercepted 15 tractor trailers carrying 20 kg, 44.1 pounds, of adrenochrome each, 1,200 kg/1,202.5 lbs. 1 kilogram is worth $1.5 bil on the market. All shipments were headed for reservation in the Yukon Territory, Canada. That reservation has a copper mine in Cooper is needed for synthetic adrenochrome production or extraction slash conversion into adrenochrome from indigenous epinephrine secreted via the adrenal glands. Adrenochrome is a neurotoxin, day rape drug, mental slash schizophrenia inducer, read up on the adrenochrome hypothesis, and used in unofficial roles as booster to superpotent opioids for targeted killing, carfentanil and those classes. The US Secret Service was been contacted by myself, and we showed them all of the evidence. And I have spoken with them one-on-one, how I found out about the other trucks, due to use finding $100 bil worth of potential cash. $4.50 to $6 trillion, in total, was trying to cross an international border. The USSS agents said that with the 15 trucks caught, it is likely 45 to 60 more crossed the border successfully for a handoff to new drivers into Calgary. I am still interrogating, the driver that the highway patrol caught. I took the case off of them.